Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to program a SIX siren into your Honeywell wireless Lyric security systems. So the SIX siren is a really revolutionary new sensor that works with this revolutionary new system. It is on the SIX technology, which is a new type of wireless technology that has been released along with this Lyric panel. And what it means is that these sensors, or SIX devices, are bi-directional, meaning they talk to and from the panel, and they're fully encrypted to this system. Once it's been enrolled to this system, it can't be enrolled to any other system unless it's been deleted in range of the panel. And once it's been learned in, it can't be hacked or spoofed or jammed or any of the things that can happen with the 5800 series sensors. Not that that stuff ever really happens or, you know, often happens, but if you can get more secure, it's nice to have the option. And that's really what the Lyric provides, is the ability to fully encrypt all of your wireless devices for the most secure wireless system in your house. And now we're going to show you how to program this sensor into the panel. When doing a Lyric installation and a Lyric programming, the very first thing to keep in mind is you should enroll the furthest sensor from the panel first. All right, so we used to tell you to bench program everything for your Lynx Touch right at the panel, program it all to the system, and then take it out to the installation location and mount it. When you're doing your Lyric, you kind of want to do things a little backwards. The first sensor, or rather the farthest away sensor, is the first one you should program. And you program it out where it's going to be really far away. That way, the sensor in the panel will analyze the Wi-Fi throughout the house and get the best transmissions from the sensors back to the panel. And that's best practice. Once you've done the furthest one away, then you can come to the panel and do the rest a little bit closer. We've already learned a few in, so we're just going to go ahead and program this right at the panel. And the next step of programming, now that we know the order of operation, is to pop it open. So on the back, we have this back plate. It slides counterclockwise and opens up. And we have these batteries, battery holders in the inside. The other order of operation, or the other really important step in the operation of programming a Lyric, is to not install the batteries or pull the battery tabs on any of your SIX series devices until you're ready to program them at that exact moment into the panel. So basically, to go to the ready to program screen, we hit security followed by tools, and our installer code is 4112. And now we're into this screen where we can hit program, and then we can go to zones. And this learns in as a zone, okay? That's a little different than the 5800 Wave, which was the 5800 wireless siren. That one didn't have to get programmed to a zone. It could work on the house ID code all by itself. You could set up a maintenance zone, but this one is more of a true sensor. It programs in like a zone. So we already have our template zones, and we've already started to program some of these. We're going to fill in the rest in a bit. But we're going to jump to zone 8, which is the first available new zone, and we click edit. Now on this part, we hit serial number, and now we're at the screen where it wants us to enroll the MAC address. And the MAC address on this device is found right here. So this siren is actually a little computer. It's got a 16-digit unique MAC address, which communicates to AlarmNet servers. This device can be firmware updated so that as new features are released, we can firmware update the specific sensor itself along with the panel so that new features are released. You're not buying new hardware every time something else new comes out. So we think that's a really awesome addition to the Lyric panel and the Lyric sensors. So now that we've reviewed all that, we're ready to install it and install the batteries and get it programmed in. So to program this sensor, it's literally as easy as popping these batteries in. So you have four that come with the panel. That come with the siren. They alternate, so positive and negative. You just want to make sure you're doing it in the right order displayed. Two of them in is enough to give the unit power, and you can see that already it's doing its learning in. I'm going to put the other two because that's how we get our maximum battery life. But again, two is enough. And you can see after that 20 second period where it's lighting up the green light, now it's learned in the MAC address, and we have a learned in siren already. Before I close it up, I'm just gonna install our last two batteries, making sure to alternate the positives and the negatives, and then we can close up the tamper. On the back here, we have Honeywell displayed on the back plate, and we have Honeywell displayed right here on the cover. So if we line them up, that's how we can get it locked into place. And if we tamper it one more time, it's locked in our serial, our MAC address, and it's calling it the wireless siren. All right, we're gonna put this one upstairs because we have our siren downstairs. This is gonna go upstairs so we can hear chimes, door chimes, window chimes, and alarm sounds upstairs. So to put in upstairs, you can hit the U and then the down arrow twice. Oh, that was the up arrow. So the down arrow twice will take you to upstairs, which is the third U word in the library. So you're not typing any old word. You're choosing words from the custom library for these zone descriptors. And in this case, upstairs is the perfect word for us. So it'll say upstairs wireless siren. And you'll see it's supervised. It cannot be selected to be unsupervised. We want it to be supervised. The only other thing you can choose is the supervision time and whether or not you get the chime noises from the siren. And of course, that's a really great feature. I can't imagine why anyone wouldn't want that, but it is selectable. And we're gonna save all of those selections. Now we see we have a healthy battery and a healthy range indication on our upstairs wireless siren. And if we exit to the home screen, using one of our programmed door contacts, we can simulate what happens with this siren chiming. So we have our door here, we open it up. And you heard the panel chime and enunciate. You also heard the siren do the same chiming. So now we know our siren worked. Even beyond that, I want to show you how cool this light is here. When we arm to stay mode, you get the arm exit beep right at the siren to let you know, okay, you're armed. And beyond that, you have this really nice red LED to show that the system is arming. If you disarm it, you get the beep to enunciate that it's now disarmed, and you get the green light that it's in the disarmed state. So this LED is really nice because it lets you know exactly what's going on. In case you look at this and you're not by the panel, you have an idea of what state the system is in. So we hope you've enjoyed that video on how to program a SIX siren to your Honeywell wireless Lyric. We're very excited about this sensor. We think this is going to be a really popular device because we get questions on the Honeywell Lynx Touch about a device that would act like this sensor exactly all the time. And we have custom ways around it, but this is really easy to just enroll it and have all of that functionality, chime, siren, audible or visual indication if the system's armed or disarmed, all of that from one device. So that's the SIX siren and how to program it to the Lyric. If you have any questions when programming your SIX siren, please email support@alarmgrid.com. And make sure to subscribe to our channel so that as we release more videos about this Lyric system, you'll be up to date on all of the great new features and sensors that are compatible with this revolutionary new system.